Good morning, students. I am Kuldeep Singh. Today, I am going to explain the class 10th topic, refraction. Students, you know that according to the new guidelines of the ICC, so some of the topics has reduced. So, in between the video, I will tell you that which all topics are reduced also. So, I hope that you all will watch this video and explain the topics, understand the topics very easily. So first of all, I'm going to explain about the refraction of light. Refraction of light. Refraction means when the ray of light, this is the medium, so when the ray of light pass from one medium to another and it bend downwards, that is refraction. And one is reflection. In the lower classes we have discussed about the reflection, and this is refraction. This is a difference between the refraction and reflection. Refraction means the ray hit on the medium and pass to the another medium. Reflection means the bouncing back the ray. Bouncing back. This ray comes, this is the ray which comes and strike on the medium, that is the incident ray. And we don't know that what is the angle, so we have to draw one angle over here. This ray is called as a normal ray. This is normal ray and this is incident ray. So, and the ray which pass and bend toward the normal, this is ray is called as refracted ray. This is refracted ray. So, the first of all, what is refraction? When the ray, incident ray comes and pass to the another medium and bend toward the normal is called as refraction. Two cases are there. The first law of the refraction is the ray comes and bends toward the normal. This is the, and when it bends toward the normal, the speed decrease. Second ray, this is the rarer medium. And this is the denser medium. And so I will explain you with the one experiment. So this is the normal, this is the rarer medium, and inside the water is the denser medium. This pencil is a straight. When I dip this pencil into the glass, in the as the ray of light, this is the ray of light, as it passes into the medium, denser medium, it bend. See, it bends toward the normal. This is called as normal. It bends toward the normal. So, speed of light decrease when it pass from rarer to denser. Second one, in the downward, when you see to the upward, this is a denser medium and this is the rarer medium. As the speed of light comes from the denser medium and pass to the rarer medium, it moves away, this away from the medium. It bends away from the medium. So, two cases are here. The first one is when a ray of light pass from the rarer to denser, it bends toward the normal. It bends toward the normal. Second case, when it pass from the, this is the denser medium and this is the rarer medium. As the ray light pass from the denser medium to rarer medium, it bend away. It goes away from the normal. This is away from the normal. So this is the second case. And in the third case, when the ray of medium passes normally, normal means 90 degree. When the ray of light pass at 90 degree, will it bend to the any side? No, it will not bend to the any side. It goes straight forward, undeviated. This is called as undeviated. Deviation. Deviation means bend. The ray of light bend from its path is called as deviation. So the third case is the ray of light normally. Normally, very important word, normally. In the physics, normal means 90 degree. Where the normal word comes, that means we are explaining about the 90 degree or 0 degree. So this is, if the ray of light comes through this side also, it will not bend to any side, it goes straight forward. Okay. So this is the normal. Second one is, what is the cause of refraction? Why this refraction caused? Because the speed of light decrease. So as the ray, you know, I will give you an example. In the winter season, when there is a fog, dense fog is there, from can you able to drive the vehicle at 60 speed? No. We can, as we start from the home, there is a sunshine is there, and our speed limit is suppose 50 to 60, and on the way the fog comes. Can we increase the speed, accelerate the speed? No. We can decrease the speed. That means the denser medium, when we pass to the denser medium, the speed will less. So same way, this is the ray medium and this is the denser medium. When the object pass or ray of light pass from the ray to denser, it bends down, means its speed decrease. This is the cause of refraction, because of the change in speed of light. Change in speed, suppose here in the ray medium speed is 3.41 meter per second, and when it comes here, it comes 2.08 or something like that. Its speed decreases. This is the cause of refraction. So what are the laws of refraction? Now I am going to explain about the laws of refraction. Laws of refraction. Reflection. But first of all, what are the laws of reflection? Reflection and refraction, little bit laws are same. What is this ray is called as? Incident ray. And this ray is called as reflected ray. This ray is called as normal ray. So when the ray light hit, so the angle between the incident ray and the normal ray is called as angle of incident, and the angle between the normal and the reflected ray is known as angle of reflection. So the angle, this is a plane mirror, angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection is the first law of refraction. Same way in the refraction also, the first one is the incident ray. This is the, what ray is called as? This ray is called as incident ray. What is this ray is called as? This is normal ray. The angle between the normal and the incident ray is called as angle of incident. As it goes straight and it bends toward the normal, so the angle between the refracted ray and the normal is called as angle of refraction. So the incident ray, refracted ray and the normal ray, how many rays are there? First incident ray, second one refracted ray, third one normal ray. All three lie on the same plane. All three lie on the same plane. This is the first law. And second one is, the second is angle of sine of incidence to the angle of sine of refraction is the second law. Incident, sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction is constant. And students, one thing I want to clear, the angle of refraction, this refraction is called as mu. In some of the books it is written as nu, N-E-W, N-E-U, and in our book there is a M-E-W, mu. We can add, say as mu also or nu also, both are same. So this is the sign of the refraction. So this is called as constant. This is sign of incidence to the sign of refraction is constant. This is the second law. And its another name, write down on your books please, its another name is, sometimes the ICC asked, define the Snell's law. Snell's law. What is Snell's law? That is angle of incidence of the sine of incidence to the angle of sine of refraction is called as Snell's law. Very important topic. So next one is, what are the effect on speed, wavelength and frequency on the refraction? The when ray of light pass from the rarer medium to the denser medium, its speed decrease. Okay, so and when the ray of light pass from the denser to the rarer, its speed increase. So second one, they can ask, the ICC has asked a 1 mark question, name the physical quantity out of wavelength, frequency and speed which does not change. Your answer should be the frequency of light depend upon the source, so it does not change on refraction. This is very important question which ICC has asked. So next one is the formula. We have the relationship between the speed, wavelength and the frequency. The relation is very important. So relation, speed is denoted by v, frequency is denoted by f, and wavelength in the 9th class also we have discussed about the wavelength is denoted by lambda. This is called as lambda. Okay, so the relationship between the speed, frequency and the wavelength, that is a lambda, is equal to v is equal to f lambda. Sometime 1 mark question they have asked about this also. Frequency speed upon wavelength. Speed upon wavelength. This is the formula for the we can calculate the speed with the help of this formula. Okay, so when the light pass from the rarer to denser medium, the wavelength decrease since speed of the light decrease, so wavelength also decrease, but its frequency unchanged. Again I am repeating this one, the physical quantity, the frequency does not change. So next one is the speed of light in the different media. When we relate the speed of light with any media, that is called as absolute zero. Okay, absolute refractive index also. When we relate any speed of light in vacuum, so what is the speed of light in vacuum? Speed of light in air or vacuum upon speed of light in any media is called as refractive index. This is the symbol of refractive index. So what is the speed of light in vacuum? That is 3 into 10 raised to power 8 meter per second upon sometime, out of these two value they will give you one value, either refractive index or either the speed of light in any media. We can find out the any one of the topic. Next one, the main question, what is the SI unit of refractive index? What is the SI unit of the refractive index? So some of the students can write it is centimeter, it is meter per second, but the refractive index has no unit. The refractive index has no unit. So refractive index has no unit. Make sure. Okay, so it has no unit. Next one is RI. RI stands for the refractive index or refraction, we can say. Okay, so one more important ICC question I'm going to explain with you, that is that if the refractive index of diamond is 2.41, what does it mean? It means the light travel in air the light travel in air 2.41 meter faster than in diamond. कि लाइट जो है वो ट्रेवल फास्ट कर रही है 2.41 मीटर देन इन डायमंड. दिस इज द मीनिंग ऑफ द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स. सो कंडीशंस, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल व्हाट इज द कंडीशन. सो वी कैन राइट द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स, दिस इज द मीनिंग. सो रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ सेकेंड मीडियम विद रिस्पेक्ट टू वन, सपोज इट इज 3/4. The refractive index of air, we can say air with respect to water is 3/4. Find out the refractive index of water with respect to air. What does it mean? So refractive index of water with respect to air is 4/3. Just to reciprocal this one, that is the meaning. So refractive index of air with respect to water is 3.4. So refractive index of water with respect to air is 4/3. So that is the main topic. Next one, condition for the light, for a light of ray to pass undeviated. What are the condition when the ray of light pass undeviated? Okay, so as I explained you in the before that also, the two conditions are there when the angle of incidence is 90 degree or 0 degree. Okay, so when the ray of light pass 90 degree, then also it goes undeviated. When the angle is 0 degree, then also it goes undeviated. This is the first condition. Second one is, if both the mediums are same, if both the mediums, suppose here is rarer and here is also rarer, will there be any change? No. So if both the mediums are same, that means the light ray pass undeviated. Or if both the, here is also water and below is also water, when both it ray light pass. So now, is there a pencil bent? Is pencil bent? No, because it passes undeviated 90 degree. Okay, so there is a no change. When now there is a bendation of pencil is there, light is there. Okay, so this is the two conditions are there. Second one is factor affecting the refractive index of medium. What are the factor which affect the refractive index of medium? The first one is nature. Students, one thing I want to clear, they will not ask you the factors, write the factors affecting the refractive index. They will raise the question like that, how the refractive index affect by the nature. So less the speed of the light. If your speed is less or any light speed is less, then more refractive index will be there. Okay, so if the one who is jumping, then they can, if the speed is more, then it can take long jump. If the speed is less, they can take a less jump. So this is the nature of the medium, means if the speed is less, more the refractive index. Second one, physical conditions such as temperature, how it depend upon the temperature. If we increase the temperature, then refractive index is decrease. So we can say that it is vice versa. Okay, so vice versa, or we can say it is the reciprocal or inversely proportional. Increase temperature is inversely proportional to the refractive index. If we increase the temperature, the refractive index will be decrease. If we decrease the refractive index, the temperature will be increase. Third one is color, how it depend upon the color. So all the colors are having a different speed. All the color. So the color which has a more speed, it has a less refractive index. So refractive index of medium decrease with increase in wavelength. So next one we are going to explain a very important topic, that is about the glass slab. Students, this is known as a glass slab. So in the lab also will perform one experiment with this glass slab. So if we see the glass slab, we can pass the ray through the glass slab, then we can So I will explain you over here. So the glass slab, how it perform verification, a law of the refraction and determination of the refractive index. So this is the, suppose this is the glass slab A, B, C, D. The ray hit over here. Put a two pins at this different points. Draw a normal over here. What is this called as? Angle of incident, because this is a incident ray. Okay, so then the ray of light look from the downward side where these two pins are positioning. Okay, so you can see that it can be at this position, at this position. So join this one, join this one. Okay, so give the name as this is P, Q, this is R, S. Then join this one and this one. What is this ray is called as? This ray is called as refracted ray or angle of refraction. This is called as angle of refraction. This is called as angle of incidence. So now the ray which comes out, that ray is called as emergent ray. This is called as emergent ray. Okay, draw normal over here also, because without normal we cannot explain any angle. So this angle, this angle is known as angle of emergence, angle of emergence. Okay, so angle of incidence and angle of refraction. Angle of refraction is always less than the angle of incidence. Listen, angle of incidence and angle of emergence both are equal. Whatever the angle, this one same as the angle of this one. Now what is this? This ray, incident ray, is supposed to be come in this path, but it goes bend downward. How much it bend downward? How much it bend downward? This, the distance between, what is this ray is called as? The incident ray. This is incident ray and this is emergent ray. The perpendicular distance, the perpendicular distance between the incident ray and the emergent ray is called as lateral displacement. That is called as lateral displacement. Is it clear what is lateral displacement? The, see, the incident ray, it, if we remove this glass slab, then incident ray is supposed to come in this direction, incident ray. Then when we keep the glass block over here, glass block over here, then it comes through this way. This is the emergent ray. Now the path of the incident ray, the distance between the path of the incident ray and the emergent ray is called as lateral displacement. Okay, so read this topic and try to explain and try to understand the topic. So what are the factor, so what are the factor on which where the lateral displacement affect? I can explain. I told the students that it is directly proportional, depend how the lateral displacement depend upon the thickness. So more the thickness, more the lateral displacement. More the angle of incidence, more the lateral displacement. More the refractive index, more the lateral displacement. Directly proportional, more. Okay, so lateral displacement is directly proportional to the thickness, directly proportional to the angle of incidence, and directly proportional to the refractive index. So students, try to read this topic and understand the things. Thank you.